This is not where you live. One word proves that, and you already know it. Water. What does water do? Does water get pulled to the surface of Earth by gravity, to the center of the Earth, towards the center of the Earth? No, that isn't what happens. If you have a lake or an ocean or any body of water, it doesn't matter how big the water is, how big the area is, it's flat. And I can prove that because of how water acts. There's a theory, a myth, that's a terrible one at that, that says that this is what's happening. And that all that water is held into towards the center of that ball. The problem with this is that that's not science at all. It's not even, I wouldn't even call it anything. It's a theory that's garbage. Because if I have a lake that's 20 miles wide, and if I pour somehow a foot of water into this side of the lake, what's this side of the lake gonna do? I can tell you what, it's gonna go up exactly 6 inches. What I'm saying is, it's all gonna be flat, no matter what. You put the water on this side, it's not gonna hold to the center, towards the center of the Earth where it is. No, it's not. It's gonna flow to the lowest point till it finds a place of rest. That's water. So don't talk about Earth being a sphere. It's not possible. Earth from the space station, it says. Okay, let's just pretend that this is just a video or camera image from somewhere looking out of the space station, okay? Is that curved line the surface of this blue thing curving? Or is that just the end of what we're seeing? We've been warned about all these things, all of them, clearly in the Bible, the book of Revelation. And it's unfortunate that people are in denial about this, or that they're in confusion or whatever, but we're living it. Revelation chapter 13, verse 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And that dragon gives its power to the beast that was and is not, the one that came up from the bottomless pit. Revelation 13, verse 2. And the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard, and his feet were as the feet of a bear. I don't want to stop in the middle, but did you know that the only way for an astronaut to get to the space station is to take a Russian Soyuz? That's the only way to do it. So it kind of does have the feet of a bear. And his mouth as the mouth of a lion, and the dragon gave him his power and his seat and great authority. Well, dragon happens to give ISS its power by resupplying it and sending cargo to it on the Falcon 9 rocket. This is not a coincidence. The Falcon 9 rocket. Revelation 13, verse 13. And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. This booster, after it delivers Dragon into orbit, the Dragon capsule, this booster returns back to Earth and lands using fire. And it says here in verse 14 that and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, Are you deceived? That's why I want to talk about Flat Earth. 2015, Flat Earth kind of made its way onto the scene. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, "Hurt not the earth, neither the sea nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads." And I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel. That was Revelation 7. And in Revelation 11, verse 7, "And when they have finished their testimony, the beast that ascendeth out of the bottomless pit shall make war against them, and shall overcome them, and kill them." Just to play along, if this beast came up from the bottomless pit, or ascendeth out of the bottomless pit, and killed a certain testimony that people had, something like Flat Earth, because what's happening is this whole world, anyone that lives on a planet, they're worshiping this beast that gets the power, its power from the dragon. And they're worshiping his image. It's right here. It's a false image, a false molten image. In Romans 1, verse 22, it says, "Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools and changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to corruptible man and to birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things." Probably something like this. "O thou that dwell upon many waters, abundant in treasures, thine end is come, and the measure of thy covetousness. The Lord of hosts hath sworn by himself, saying, Surely I will fill thee with men as with caterpillars, and they shall lift up a shout against thee. He hath made the earth by his power, he hath established the world by his wisdom, and hath stretched out the heaven by his understanding. When he uttereth his voice, there is a multitude of waters in the heavens, and he causeth the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. He maketh lightnings with rain, and bringeth forth the wind out of his treasures. Every man is brutish by his knowledge. Every founder is confounded by the graven image. For his molten image is falsehood, and there is no breath in them. They are vanity, the work of their errors. In the time of their visitation, they shall perish."